Hello, hello. Welcome to another episode of Stitch on Saturday with me. Last week I showed you guys how to do the foundation row and do the Tunisian simple stitch. And I forgot to mention that when you pick up the loops, it's called a forward pass, and then when you're pulling through, when you're going back, it's called the return pass. Let's get started. Today I'm going to show you how to do changing colors and how to do color work when you're doing Tunisian crochet. So right now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 loops on here, and I'm going to show you how to make a square in the middle with, I'm going to use yellow here, this yellow mustard, whatever you want to call it. So today I'm using big twist yarn. And it's a worsted weight size 4 yarn, and I'm using a US 10.5 6.5 mm Tunisian crochet hook. So let's get started. So I'm gonna pull through one, and then pull through two, pull through two, pull through two. So I'm going to do four of the green on each side and then do a square in the middle here. I don't join on the return pass. Let me just do the return pass as I would normally. And for this, you can check out the previous video. So that is the return pass. So now when you're doing the forward pass, that's when you join in the other color. So I'm going to work to the center. I'm going to pull up the loops as I would normally do on my forward pass. So I have four loops now. And then in the middle here, I am going to... So this is what you have to do. Basically, just go around so that you have... So it's going to just be tight when you do the loops. So here we go. Pick up a loop. And then remember to just close tight in the back, like this. So it's gonna continue picking up the loops with the yellow. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm gonna pick up four, and then there's gonna be a float in the back, but this is what we do. So then just hold that in the back like this, over the yarn, over the green yarn. So then you pull up a loop, pull up a loop, pull up a loop, and pull up a loop. So there we have. So now we've added the yellow. So we've added the yellow, and then we're just gonna work a normal return pass, but with the changing colors. So we don't have to do anything extra here, you're just doing the normal return pass. So that's how we do that. But again, you're gonna hold the yarn over like this. When you have one of the color A left on your hook, that's when you wanna switch colors. So you wanna pull through the two loops with the yellow. And then pull through two loops, pull through two loops, pull through two loops. And again here, when you have one yellow left, that's when you would want to go back to the green. So again, yeah, make this a little bit looser because it's going to be a float, it's going to be tight in the back. So you want to make sure it's a little loose. Pull through two loops, pull through two loops, pull through two loops. There you have it. That's your color changes. So now I'm going to just work the return pass like I normally would. Okay. And then again, when you have the yellow, you want to go back to it. Remember to do that where you're putting the yarn over so that there's no hole there. So pull through, pull through, pull through, pull through. And that. And then again here, you want to Now you want to go to the green, the mint green that I have today. So you want to do that. And then go back to the return pass. The return pass is the one that's kind of tricky because now, right before you have to change, when you have one green left on here, one green loop left, that's when you want to change. So cross over in the back, pull through two loops, pull through two loops, pull through two loops. So there you have the yellows. You don't want to have the floats in the back like this. You could work with two separate skeins of yarn, but I'm okay because it's not too big of a float. So you want to just pull through again when you have just one yellow left and you want to switch back to the green. That's what you do. And then you want to pull through two loops. So you can see the shape forming here, the square. I'll do one more. So there, pull through. So you want the green. You want to switch. There's the yellow. There's the yellow. And the yellow. Then you want to switch back to the green. That's the forward pass. And then here's the return pass. You have one left. That's when you want to pull through with the yellow. And make sure to cross over in the back so that this is what it looks like. There's our square. Now I'm gonna go and continue with just the green. So you want to stop doing the color changes, just don't pick the loops up with the yellow, just pick them up with the green. And you always want to do that on the forward pass. You want to switch colors again on the forward pass, because if you do it on the return pass, you'll have green over here where you don't want it. So that's how you're gonna do it. And there we have that. Pick up a loop here. There's my square, and then let me just do that. So it's a great technique because it just opens up the possibilities of pretty much doing any design. You could do any shape. My most recent pattern that I will be releasing this coming week is for my Creamsicle Crochet baby blanket. And it requires this color work. So if you feel comfortable doing this, then you can go ahead and get my pattern when I release it. So I'll be releasing it on Thursday night. You can go check out pictures on my profile. You can go see my own pictures, and then also pictures that my testers took. You can even actually make it into a wall hanging like one of my testers did. She did a really good job. So there you have it, the square. It's orange and I love the green, and that's how you do color work. I hope you enjoyed this and found it useful, and I hope you're able to make lots of fun designs using this technique. Alright, thanks for joining in for Stitch on Saturday. I'll see you next week.